In this unassuming USPS box that looks like somebody wiped their shoes on it, there is a highly unique RTX 3070. And in today's video, we're gonna do some stuff to it. Okay, the person who sent this clearly lost the original packaging. I feel you, that's fine, it happens all the time. Ooh, it's a gain word card. Phoenix. Now this RTX 3070 that was very kindly sent over by a Discord member may look like a common garden RTX 3070 with its blow-through cooler design and label saying it is a normal RTX 3070. But no, it's a whole lot more than that. The owner sent this card to a technician who desoldered the standard 8 gigs of GDDR6 and replaced it with 16 gigs, and apparently the card works. I am so excited to see how it runs. But before I drop this in a system, I just have to take the cooler off and admire plugged slots 69's handiwork. Oh no, they had to go through the warranty void if removed sticker to get to the PCB, and if that doesn't void your warranty, I'm pretty sure soldering an extra 8 gigs of video memory to the PCB would probably do the trick. Just lift that off, and then that is the back of the PCB, which looks a lot less savage than I was expecting. Clearly, stuffed slots really knows their way around a soldering iron. Oh, I think we're gonna have to unscrew the IO shield as well. Ah, yes, that came loose very easily. Oh, the little fan connector is my nemesis. I'm gonna have to censor this process. Yeah, I don't know. To my untrained eye, I am real impressed with what I'm looking at here. From the imager album, it seemed like all of the memory slots were filled to start with, and then plugged slots 69, giggity, desoldered all of them and replaced them with higher capacity modules. So every single one of these modules is new. It was replaced after the fact. It just looks like it came like this from the factory. This is real impressive stuff to me. The only sign of kerfuffle is an RGB connector that seems to have had a house fire. I really want to see this 16 gig 3070 work, so I'm gonna reclothe it now and then drop it in a system and see how it runs. Now apparently the card is a little bit temperamental, so we do have to be nice to it today. I think it should be fine on initial boot. We just have to do things like force core frequencies and stuff. But before we get into that, let's see what happens when we turn it on. The power supply is not plugged in. Okay, if it doesn't turn on now, then I should be worried. Okay. Ooh, I like that RGB implementation, like around the fan here. It's flashing a little. Continuing to have a seizure. Fixing the seizures was relatively straightforward. All I had to do was enable boost locking in EVGA's X1 precision tool, and then it was just kind of fine. Apparently, the MacGyvered card does not handle core frequency fluctuations well. Ooh, and would you look at that? The drivers have no problem identifying the 16 gigs of video memory on our RTX 3070. So with the card just being fine, I'm gonna test it in a couple of phases, starting off with the standard game gamut phase. Cool, even GTA 5 recognizes it, although doesn't seem particularly interested in using any of it. Yay, GTA 5 is running. You can see we're very much using the 16 gigs of memory in this old game at 1440p. So I've even cranked the advanced settings in GTA 5, and I think that's why we're hovering around 120 frames per second. Wow, we're actually getting less memory allocation than we did with GTA 5. That's interesting. Now, I am using 1440p high settings because those are the settings I would use for Battlefield 5 with a 3070 normally. They just make sense to me. Temperature-wise, this card is doing very well. With its 240-ish watts of usage, we're just getting about 55°C. That's good. Wait, I quickly want to jump up to 4K to see what that does for the memory allocation. Okay, so 4K has added about 2 gigs of memory utilization. And actually, at this resolution, the 3070 is still doing great. We're getting about 100 frames per second. Oh, it didn't save with my fancy car that I stole. Okay, well, I guess, what can you do? So with Cyberpunk running at 1440p high settings, at 1440p, it's using the same amount of video memory as Battlefield 5 did at 4K, which makes me curious. What happens when we bump this up to 4K? Well, the first thing that apparently happens is the frame rate drops a lot. The 3070 does not like 4K on Cyberpunk, at least at high settings. And interestingly, in terms of video memory usage, it's barely crept up. I then bravely cranked the preset up to Ray Tracing Ultra at 4K, which finally made the graphics card realize it had more than 8 gigs available, apparently. But despite our colossal reserve of memory, the game's still running like a sloth on cough syrup. At which point, I decided to drop in a standard, pathetic 8 gig version of the RTX 3070 as a point of comparison. Unfortunately, the only version I have available is this Dell RTX 3070, which may not be the finest example of one, but we'll see how it goes. For the Dell 3070, I did also do the boost lock mode thing in EVGA just to have a more apples to apples comparison. And one thing to note is that the core frequency is lower. It's not pegged at 2 gigahertz like the other card is. So hopefully that doesn't impact the performance too much. And with that reduction in core frequency, you can see that our power draw is also a smidgen lower than it was with the other card. But apparently the core frequency difference didn't matter much because the results were basically within the margin of error. Not only with GTA 5, but also Battlefield 5 and Cyberpunk. And with Cyberpunk, I had to crank it all the way up to 4K Ultra Ray Tracing settings, which are frankly obscene settings, for the additional video memory to make a difference. And it's not like it was playable on the 16 gig variant, so it feels a bit like comparing degrees of super cholera. Which I think means moving on to phase 2 of the testing, finding a game which the 16 gig version can run well, but curb stomps the 8 gig variant. Well, okay. The owner mentioned that Escape from Tarkov was one of the few games they could get higher than 8 gigs of video memory utilization, and that's clearly happening here with 1440p medium settings. Tarkov is a thirster boy. Now, I do want to try high texture settings at 4K, but I can't change that in raid. So let me go to an offline raid with the higher settings and see what happens. Holy crap. Okay, so with the textures turned up to high at 4K, we're maxing out the video memory. That's pretty crazy. I mean, that is allocation, but still. A very big number, and it was easy to get to. Like, the first game we looked for was the one that did the thing. This is Streets, which is the new map, and it's known to give some pretty terrible frame rates, but this isn't too bad. Even at these settings that I definitely wouldn't use for Escape from Tarkov, even with a more powerful graphics card. Interestingly, with Escape from Tarkov, despite wildly different memory allocation at these high settings, the performance is basically the same. Also, with the 8 gig variant in the system, there's significantly higher normal RAM allocation. Interesting. I then moved over to Microsoft Flight Simulator, which in no way involved the learning curve for me to figure out how to play again. Here, using 4K high settings, Microsoft Flight Simulator didn't seem to care about the extra video memory either. It seemed to be the same story using Control with 4K and irresponsibly high ray tracing settings, although on the 8 gig card, the plant did freak out a bit, and on close inspection, the textures weren't quite as crisp, but in terms of subjective performance, they felt indistinguishably terrible. Crysis Remaster at 4K very high ray tracing settings ran slightly better on the MacGyver card, but in practice they felt and looked the same. At which point I felt like I had to up the ante with some truly unoptimized piles of crap. Oh Okay, that's interesting. With The Last of Us running at 1440p Ultra settings, they're running surprisingly similarly. Although the 8GB version is noticeably more stuttery, but I was expecting the game to run like a jammed fax machine on the 8GB card. It seems like they've finally patched the game to a point of borderline usability. And finally, moving over to Resident Evil 4, but again, at 1440p 8GB textures, look at that, the 8GB card is struggling quite a bit more than the MacGyver variant. Although, it is definitely still playable with the standard card. Which brings me to the end of my time with this insanely well done 16GB mod of the RTX 3070. Thank you very much for sending it over, and until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye bye.